I'm headed out to Anaheim, California right now to meet novice flippers Kevin and Corey, and they just bought a vintage house by the famous architect Cliff May. These homes tend to be beautifully maintained and an incredible mid-century property, but these two might be in over their heads. So we're gonna see how it goes. It's definitely a Cliff May house. Look at this. It has the vaulted ceilings, a bunch of glass. This is nice, the original brick right here.
Yeah.
So like in here, what would your plans be?
I would love to tear these ceilings and see if they have the exposed beams.
It would be awesome if you had exposed beams under the drywall, but did you include that into the $75,000 bid?
No.
I mean, I have my own ideas, but really I feel like that's where we need your help as well, is kind of like, what are buyers looking for in a Cliff May house?
There's two ways to tackle this project, right? One is we try to keep as much of the original as we can, or two, we kind of redo everything to give that original feel, but everything's new.
Yeah, I'd like to go that route, if possible.
I think I like that route.
You like the new route? Okay, no, that's fair, that's fair. With an architectural home, you have to budget it if you're gonna do it right. Restoring original features is just a great way to go. But in Kevin and Corey's case, modernizing is the smarter move. They'll be able to use less expensive materials as long as the overall look is right. Those updates are gonna fit better with the way that people live now. An example of that would be this brick wall. Would you guys want to keep this wall because it's original, or would you want to take it out?
I personally would love to take the whole thing out.
Yeah, I think we would remove it just to kind of open the space up.
What do you envision happening in this area?
I think it would be nice to kind of extend the kitchen this way, maybe add a peninsula to have some sort of seating space, but it still feels open.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'd run a new countertop from this corner right here, and I'd run it all the way, like super long countertop, and then I'd even do a waterfall edge, like more of a modern end.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
I kind of want to go the more like mid-century modern, but more like a minimalist kind of look where it does mix the warm tones and, you know, with the wooden cabinets.
And what would you think it's going to cost, like, to remodel all this in here?
I'm going to guess maybe like $12,000.
I think you're pushing, because that means a pretty big kitchen area, you're probably looking 15 to 16. Ooh, this is one orange bedroom, huh?
Yeah, it is.
Ooh, stinky room, too.
Yeah. So what about this? The room is pretty small. Would you waste money in knocking this out and making this room bigger?
If it was a primary bedroom, yes. If it's not the primary, I'd probably just leave it, save money.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so decent-sized bathroom, definitely not original, was remodeled. So this would be a full gut in here. What do you think it would cost you?
I'm gonna say $7,000.
Yeah, probably 8 to 10.
Okay.
Probably 8 to 10. Okay, so this bedroom is actually bigger than the other one.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
A lot more natural lighting in here, too.
Like, what would you guys want to do?
Flooring.
Rip it out, yeah.
All right, so this is bedroom 3.
Yeah.
All right, so again, it's definitely old school. You can see how they just built, like, the boxed-out closet.
What about this side of it? I mean, I feel like, what do we do with that space? Would you suggest keeping all this original?
Here's the thing, right? Like, it's actually, if you look on the ground, it's not a big bedroom.
Right.
But the way it's built, the bedroom feels bigger because of the vaulted ceilings and because you have the gap. So imagine if this was drywall running up and this was drywall running up. See how tight this space would be?
Yeah, it would be very small.
So this is primary. This is funky. It's a walk-in closet. What is this thing?
It's supposed to be.
Yeah, it is. It works. I call it a walk-in. So they started some work in here.
Yeah. So what do you think?
It's pretty nice, actually. Eesh. What's going on there?
I don't know.
We have some water damage, dry rot. Yeah. Well, at least you have a private bathroom, but this whole thing's going to need to be reframed. You're going to need new wood, new everything in here. Probably about 10 grand or so. So we're designing both bathrooms today, right?
Right. On top of the stress of the flip, we have a busy family life. So today, our two youngest are here with us, and we're hoping we could still be productive.
Do we have a budget yet?
We're looking about $3,500 per bathroom.
Did you want to match the bathrooms or do them differently?
I'd be open to keeping them at least a little bit similar to maybe, like, keep it in budget that way.
Well, so typically mid-century modern homes are more design-focused.
Yeah.
So I think it would actually be a good idea to do them differently. They can be similar, but I think they should be different.
Yeah. I was thinking terrazzo is mid-century modern, and it's pretty popular right now. So I really, really was hoping that we can do something like that, maybe for the flooring.
So I've done terrazzo a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty darn expensive. How much do you think this is a foot?
$7.
$15.
$15?
$15. So with our $3,500 budget, we can sell the house with no shower, no tub, no vanity.
Just terrazzo.
Wow.
So that's going to be a little bit out of budget, but I like the look. I like the direction of the design.
Okay.
You're going to help today. All right. Look at you. Jackpot. This is porcelain. Ooh. Looks like terrazzo, though.
It does.
I like its size.
I like it.
Okay, you know what? Let's go find a table. Let's put some things down. We'll mix and match.
Well, for sure, I like this for the flooring.
Okay.
I like this combo right here.
And this would be for the primary bathroom.
I think I like color for the guest bathroom, neutral for the primary.
So this is our final look for the primary, the terrazzo, the white penny rounds, and that tile. It honestly, it's very cohesive, and it looks great together. And then for the guest bathroom, it's a very similar look, but we're going to go with the more green tile.
Yeah.
I like it.
I like it.
We did it.
We
designed two bathrooms.
High five.
You got a high five?
She's like, now it's time to eat. Now it's time to eat. What are you guys most nervous about?
Well, I know that, you know, the Cliff May is a very particular home, so it's not going to appeal to every buyer.
Mm-hmm. I think I'm nervous about the ceilings.
So hopefully we don't have any, like, Cliff May experts, because if we do, we're in trouble.
Oh, no. I'm excited to see this house.
It's nice, babe.
What?
I like the privacy of it. It's a lot of greenery.
All I see is the garage, but I see that the house is tucked away.
Yeah, a lot of bushes in the front.
And... By the way, I love the exterior of the house, the dark paint colors. I think it looks great.
Courtyard is nice.
I love this.
It's like classic. It's unique. I like it.
I don't know about classic.
What do you think about this?
Concrete.
It's uneven. The kids are going to trip all day long.
What happened there? Why is the concrete all messed up?
Well, we kind of ran out of the stone. We got as close as possible to the planter, and then they just kind of cemented.
I know you put the concrete in, but you could have found stones that weren't perfect, but close.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. I like the open concept.
Oh, floors are shiny.
Okay, the floors are a little shiny.
It's they just painted it or something. I've never seen that.
Me either.
I like the beams of the ceiling and also that window.
You can see the living room, the dining room, the kitchen.
Remember that like weird like wall they had up?
Yeah.
Taking that down, expanding the island, reconfiguring things made a huge difference.
Yeah.
I love the island.
And a deep sink.
Yes.
You know how much I love that.
I like these finishes, too.
Yeah?
The dark woods with the gold finishes. Yeah. Is this a room here?
Oh, your office.
Ooh. Oh, yeah, this is a nice little office.
And look, it's like right by the pool.
This is nice. I love this color of the tile in the shower.
That is nice.
I like this. This is good.
Mm-hmm.
And the gold, more gold.
Love how you guys designed the bathroom.
I would probably like a little more counter space, but I guess this is more for guests.
Super cute, but so little.
I like this. This is actually kind of different. I'm here for it. Oh.
Save the best for last.
You guys nailed the design. Future projects, maybe hire a little bit better of workers.
Yeah.
So, I love the open concept of like the windows and the air and the light.
This is a good size.
Yes, counter space. Oh, this is nice, honey.
Yeah, that's a pretty big shower. I probably had like a glass partition.
Yeah, and I can't lie, a curtain is not the look for this. We're not.
No curtains.
We're not doing that.
To pay $949? That's kind of steep.
How does it feel? You feel at home?
I could live here.
Yeah?
Actually, yeah, I could definitely live here.
Yes.
Are we talking offer?
We got a couple more places to see, but this is definitely at the top of the list.
We might have found a buyer.
Maybe.